Hello, Lakers fans. Trevor Lane, senior writer for LakersNation.com, and this is the Lakers Nation news feed where we break down all the latest Lakers news. Well, we are right in the thick of free agency, and the Lakers have finally signed someone. Before we dive into it, quick shout out to our sponsors, betonline.ag, your home for online gambling. All you have to do is go to clnsmedia.com/LeBron, enter the promo code CLNS50 to get a 50% bonus on your first deposit, and Uptime Energy Drink. So energy should feel. You can find them at 7-Eleven, GNC, or get a whole case of them like I do at Amazon.com and help get you through free agency. So we know the Lakers are still in hot pursuit of Kawhi Leonard, still waiting for a decision. Of course, free agency technically isn't even 24 hours old at this point. Not uncommon for star players to take a little while to eventually make a decision. They have to meet with teams and all of that. This year, however, players have been coming off the board extremely quickly. So more than Kawhi taking a long time, it feels like this year is just players are coming off the board quicker. So by contrast, it feels like Kawhi Leonard is taking longer than normal. But still, the Lakers are in the running, the Clippers are in the running, Toronto Raptors still in the running, and we are waiting to find out what his decision is going to be. In the meantime, the Lakers have actually signed someone. They signed Troy Daniels, a shooter who played last season with the Phoenix Suns, 41% shooter from three for his career, 27 years old. So he's been in the league for a bit now. He actually had some big games against the Lakers back when he was with the Memphis Grizzlies. This is a guy who can light things up from deep, but he's not going to bring a whole heck of a lot else. There isn't a whole lot else to his game. He's not a great defender or anything like that. He's not really a true point guard that's going to come in and handle the ball a bunch for you. But look, for a Lakers team that didn't have shooting last year, there's no problems with this deal. It's a veteran minimum deal, so that means that there's basically no risk. It's the lowest contract that you can possibly give him. It's not going to count against the salary cap, because after you've used all your cap space, you can sign as many veteran minimum deals as you want. So this is a deal that's just agreed to, but in terms of order of execution, they're not actually going to sign this deal until after the Lakers have spent all of their cap space. So this does not impact their chase for Kawhi Leonard at all. But it does mean that finally, hey, look, the Lakers have signed somebody. It's been a tough, two days as the Lakers have been watching all of these top free agents come off the board. Guys like Seth Curry, Trevor Ariza, players like that were certainly going to be targets for them that wind up going elsewhere. Now, they still have some serious openings. There's not that many players under contract. They're going to have to fill out the rest of the roster. But again, it all comes down to Kawhi Leonard and what he's going to do. And let's face it, I wrote a piece about this for LakersNation.com. This is the right move. As tough as it is to watch these players go off the board, some of these contracts are not going to look so good in a year or two. These deals may end up being albatrosses. So for the Lakers to wait and wait out these teams that are willing to blow big bucks on role players, that may actually help them out. Because as the cap space starts to dry up, they're going to have some opportunities to land some guys on cheaper deals than what they would get otherwise, as long as they kind of wait out the teams that still have cap space. So that's what you're seeing right now. I know it's tough. It's tough to sit back and watch these top targets, guys like Seth Curry, come off the board, and frustrating to a degree. But again, if the Lakers land Kawhi Leonard, it's worth it, because you are talking about a big three of Kawhi, LeBron James, and Anthony Davis, which is arguably the most talented in all of NBA history. I mean, think about that. The most talented in the entire history of the NBA. That is what is at stake here. That is what the Lakers could wind up with. And if that's an option, that is something that you absolutely gamble on, especially given how wide open the Western Conference looks right now. Other moves have been made, of course, around the league. D'Angelo Russell, strangely enough, winds up with the Golden State Warriors in a sign and trade. Kevin Durant goes east to the Brooklyn Nets. Kyrie goes to the Nets. Jimmy Butler seems to be locked into going to the Miami Heat. Other guys are coming off the board. Kemba Walker landing with the Boston Celtics. Terry Rozier going to the Charlotte Hornets. You've got all these other pieces that have been moving. The NBA is in a huge state of flux. I don't think we've seen anything like this before. But again, that big domino that everyone is still waiting for is to find out whether or not Kawhi Leonard is going to make that leap and create a super team with your Los Angeles Lakers. Guys, that's about it for now. Make sure you head over to LakersNation.com for more on this story and everything else going on in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers. Follow us on social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram, and make sure you keep it tuned to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, see ya.